Together Together stars Patti Harrison as Anna, a young loner who becomes the gestational surrogate for a single man in his 40s named Matt, played by Ed Helms. Soon the two strangers come to realize this unexpected relationship will challenge their perceptions of connection, boundaries, and the particulars of love. This is written and directed by Nicole Beckwith, and this is her second feature film, and after a successful premiere at Sundance earlier this year, it had a theatrical run in late April before getting a VOD release on May 11th. And I gotta say, this film was so refreshing. I had one giant smile on my face the entire time, and the more it sat with me after seeing it, the more I liked it. It's a smaller scale film that does feel like your typical indie comedy, but does something a bit different by focusing on a platonic friendship between these two seemingly different individuals. While there's a nice cast here that also includes Tig Notaro, Nora Dunn, Fred Melamed, and Julio Torres, this film rests heavily on Ed Helms and Patti Harrison's shoulders, and I gotta say, I really enjoyed both their performances. Now, I gotta admit, I'm not a huge Ed Helms fan. Not that I dislike him, but he's someone who needs the right script in order to really shine, like in Cedar Rapids or Jeff Who Lives at Home, and once again, that's the case here. He still plays that awkward goofball we've seen him play countless times like in The Office, but here he channels that energy into a much more grounded, sweeter sort of guy. He says and does the wrong things at times, but he means well, and he also doesn't go too over the top with his faux pas, so it made him feel so much more relatable than just about any other character of his in recent memory. This is also the first major role I've seen of Patti Harrison's, and I thought she was absolutely wonderful. While she does play things a bit close to the chest at times, due to Anna's attempts at trying to keep some distance between the two at first, she's still given plenty of opportunities to show off her great sense of comedic timing. She has some really funny lines, but is still able to get some of her character's emotional depth out to the forefront, finding a nice balance between humorous and heartfelt moments. I'd say the best way to describe this film would be sweet, but awkward. There are a lot of jokes centered around the fact that, due to the odd nature of their relationship, Anna and Matt often get mistaken for a couple, and sometimes they even act like a couple, with little gestures like Matt stopping by Anna's job to give her tea, or even getting her a gift at one point. But things never go down the romantic comedy route with these two, and I'm glad Beckwith decided not to do that. Not that I have anything against romantic comedies, but these two leads had such a unique dynamic to them where they'd awkwardly stumble their way through this friendship that often got confused as a romantic relationship that it would have been such a shame to ruin it by just falling back on one of the oldest movie tropes out there. The only thing that people may have against this is that it's not exactly an ambitious movie. The sweet but awkward tone that I mentioned is literally the exact same feel this movie has from start to finish. And I mean it works, as I'm all about tonal consistency, and it still allows for a fair share of both emotional and hilarious moments. It's just that the emotional peaks here only go so high as a result, because it always stays at this one particular energy level and very rarely deviates from it. Like, even when there's conflict between these two, it's never in the form of huge outbursts, and more often than not, it gets resolved pretty quickly. But that's still fine. Not every single movie needs to have earth-shattering, end-of-the-world type drama. Sometimes a film can be effective by being laid back and act as something you can just turn on if you need to put a smile on your face, and that's how I felt after seeing this. It might just go down as the year's most adorable movie to me. Its goals are simply to charm you and make you laugh with two relatable characters for 90 minutes, and because it succeeded there, it's definitely worth your time. It's on VOD, so give it a watch if you haven't seen it yet. Together Together gets an 8 out of 10. So let me know, did you see Together Together, or are you planning to see it, and what were your thoughts? Did you find it funny? Do you have a favorite Ed Helms movie? Let me know in the comments below so we can discuss. Also, if you enjoyed this video, please like it and share it, and for more movie reviews and film discussion, please make sure to hit that subscribe button to stay updated. Thanks for watching, everyone, and keep having fun with film.